What's going on, guys? I'm Highway 115, and welcome to the very first map guide in my series for Black Ops 3. Today, we are starting with the OG, the one, the only, Nacht Der Untoten. The iconic beginning of Call of Duty Zombies, the one that started it all. There's not a whole lot to this map, honestly, so this will be a much shorter video than most of my other videos, but it just made sense to start at the beginning. So without further ado, let's dig in. Alright, let's start off with a little bit of history about this map. So, Nacht Der Untoten, which translates from German to English as Night of the Living Dead, was first featured on World at War all the way back in 2008 as a secret bonus mode when you beat the campaign, and turned into an overnight sensation. Almost 10 years ago, this map cemented zombies into the Call of Duty franchise, creating a legacy which has reached massive heights all these years later. Nacht returned in Black Ops 1 as part of the Resurrection pack, which contained remasters of all of the World at War zombie map and was also a featured section in Green Run on Black Ops 2. Its final appearance came with Black Ops 3. Inside of Revelations, you can find a recreation of Nacht in the center hub of that map. And finally, a full-fledged remaster came with the Zombie Chronicles DLC, which of course is the version that we are playing today. It goes without saying that Treyarch values this map and its iconic roots. Alright, moving on to map layout. You start here in spawn. There's Mule Kick, the only perk machine on the map. RK5 wall by right there. Gobblegum machine on the left. Shiva wall by there. Then you're going to make your way over here into this room. You have a mystery box. And a couple of wall bys on the other opposite end of the room. The CUDA there on the left. And the KRM-262. That's pretty much it for down here. Next stop, head upstairs, KN-44 wall by right there, Wonder Fizz machine, Gobblegum machine. Down here you'll find the Argus wall by, and the Locus is in the cabinet for 5,000 if you want it. Move over here to this room, you'll have a Feral wall by there, and Grenade wall by in the far corner over here, and that's it. That is the entire map. It's very small. So before I get into the tutorials for the two Easter eggs, very small Easter eggs on Nacht, I want to show you guys some of my survival tactics. This is my favorite camping strategy. Sit here at the end of this hallway and just shoot at these zombies as they come. You don't really have to worry about any coming from behind you. So there are no spawns behind you. There is a spawn there. There is a zombie window there. But you could just check that from time to time. Make sure none are coming at you. And just focus on this area. And try to survive for as long as possible. Next thing you're going to want to do is organize your gobblegums. There is no pack-a-punch on this map. So you're going to want crate power, wall power, so you can pack a punch your weapons. On the house, I like to use that just to get some free perks since there are no perk machines. Bullet boost, that will double pack any of your weapons that you have packed. And extra credit, just to get some points to get ready for buying all this stuff. So first up on our notable weapons, we have the monkey bomb, which if you have crate power before you pull it out of the box, your monkey will be upgraded and provide an extra level of damage to the zombies. As you can see, when they walk into that ray, they just kind of disintegrate. They'll still explode, they'll still run towards it, just like the monkey bomb normally does. Next up on our weapons list is the ray gun. That is in the box on Nacht. It works the same as it always does. The fire rate's not the greatest, but the damage output is pretty good. We also have the thunder gun. You can get this out of the box as well, and it is the best weapon you can get on this map. Very powerful, especially for high rounds. It'll take out complete hordes of enemies if you're training, so I would definitely recommend getting this one. Last but not least, the Annihilator Pistol is available on this map. It is the special weapon that you can use. It doesn't take a normal weapon slot, and it recharges over time. Not great fire rate, but if you line up the zombies, it'll take them all out in one shot most of the time. So it's definitely a useful tool to get you out of some sticky situations. Alright, for the first Easter egg, not really an Easter egg, it's just more of a hidden secret. There are these barrels all around the map. Shoot three of them till they burn, like this, and just wait for them to explode. Like that. And once you've done that, come over here to this room, shoot this radio. You don't have to press square, just shoot it, and you'll start to hear music. Very faint, it's not very loud, but it'll be everywhere. And that's pretty much it. Last but not least, we have Samantha's Lullaby. You're going to look for four different switches around the map. There's the first one. Press square and you'll hear a clicking noise. The second one is up here, all the way in the corner of this room. You'll see it on the side of the wall here. Just press square, you should hear that clicking noise again. And the third one is here on the ceiling. You kind of have to do a running jump. It's not very hard to get to. Just do a running jump and then immediately press square when you're in the midair and you should hear that clicking noise. Last one up here on the side of this wall near the ceiling. You got it right. You should hear that confirmation noise of Samantha. You're going to want to head to this RK5 wall by and look on the ground. You'll see this Samantha doll here. Press square on it and it should vanish like that. Now you're going to look for Samantha doll locations and shoot them. Here's the first one above the Wonder Fizz, right there. The second location is right here. This is kind of hard to do. You'll be in spawn here. Just jump up and look in this ceiling. It's kind of tucked away there in the corner. I tried to jump and shoot, but that is the harder way to do it. You can just shimmy to the right here, and you can see the top of it and get it easily. Third location, right here. In this pool of water outside the building. Just look at it, it's kind of hard to see, but you'll see it spin in there and shoot it. Fourth location, outside the zombie window here on top of that truck. You see her spinning right there. Okay, fifth location, upstairs across from the locust. You'll see her on that telephone pole right there. Sixth location, in spawn outside this window on a fence post. Seventh location is up these stairs out this zombie window right next to a generator. And the eighth and final location, look out this window right next to Mule Kick, and you'll see her on the end of that tank barrel. And once you get about four of these, you'll hear that noise and then you'll be done, essentially. Your reward for completing this, hold square on the Samantha doll here. You get a max ammo. And Samantha's Lullaby will begin to play. And that's it. That is everything there is to know about Nacht Der Untoten. I hope you all enjoyed this trip down memory lane looking back at the humble beginning of Call of Duty Zombies. If you found this video informative in any way, please drop a like and comment. And subscribe to the channel for more map guides and zombies content. I'm Highway 115 and I'll catch you next time.